I think I'm done. It went fast. It went fast. Hi, folks. Welcome back to Golden Final Spin. I think I'm done the setup. Well, kind of. But first, I gotta introduce you to someone. Where are you at, hobo? Hobo!
Here is hobo. Story behind hobo.
Is hobo showed up 2-3 nights ago. It was like midnight. This little kitten scared the living daylights out of me. And he showed up out of nowhere. And we can't seem to find his owner. So we gave him a cute little flea collar. Actually, it's not cute. It's just a white collar. Right, hobo? And he goes out at night. And then comes back every day when I'm out here doing things in the shop, pricing and stuff like that. So I guess he's like a shop cat now, not a farm cat. But we're not keeping him. He's not going into the house. I have another cat and I have another dog. We just don't want another cat. But we will foster him, take care of him, pick up some, no advertising, some kitty chow. We'll take care of him. Hopefully he survives outside because he can't stay in the record shop. But we'll take care of you, hobo. Anyhow, so new record store cat. Meow, meow. So we're done the shop basically set up. Over here, I have a bunch of used records. Not very many, but here are some box sets. I had no room on the wall to put anything. Some Soundgarden, a couple Garth Brooks, Rolling Stones. What was that? Black Sabbath. Yeah, and a bunch there. Some Elvis. These here are pretty interesting. I got these almost a year ago. And you don't really see them around too much. These are, well, that's nothing. They're punk albums. Punk albums. What else is around here? Got some new cool curtain blinds. Had to keep the heat out of here. These are pretty cool because, look at this. Never seen anything like that before. And then they go all the way up. We have tons and tons and tons and tons of books. These are all music-related books, biographies, documentaries on different artists. And down here, not many people seek them out, but these are all concert Blu-ray DVDs that I collected over the past year. And this is my CD section. Now, these look like they're brand new, but they're actually not. I'll give you an example. So what I do is I buy the plastic brand new, and then I resleeve them. So they look brand new, and I'm not going to market them as brand new. I'm going to be open with people. I inspected every CD. If it had a scratch, I didn't take it. I didn't buy it. So there's all my CDs. This is our new section. Lots of new stuff. Well, one of the hardest things to find for a record store. Fleetwood Mac rumors. I guess they go off the shelf like crazy. Not repressing anything right now of them. What else can I show you? So this is my blues section in here. That's not really blues. So I got to do a lot of sorting out of stuff. Sash Jordan. Love this blues album. Wish she put something out when years ago, but didn't. And then we come over to here. These are all mixed. This is my country section. Lots of country people seek out. Amazing album. This is Gordon Lightfoot's solo stuff. It's all acoustic. This is a new album by Dwight Yoakam. I think I showed that in the last video. George Strait, new album. Cold Beer, Conversations. Then we come up into this section here. This is going to be our jazz section. Lots of Miles Davis and the Monk. What else? I'll just give a little skim through some different things. I do have a glass cabinet that's going to come in. That will go over where that broom is. And then there's going to be a listening station here. More books up here. I wanted to put my box sets up there, but I turned out that I had more books. I actually have more books. So my shelving, I had these plastic things that hook in, which I didn't know. I ordered them because I ordered them so long ago, and they worked out okay for there. Some accessories that are going to be in the shop when and if we ever do finally open up. Clean solutions and stuff like that. Some preamps. My favorite cartridge, this one here, the MP110H, comes with the head shell and everything. And then the area for the till. And then I had to put some kind of thing on the windows so that people aren't peeking in. So, that's it. Yes, hobo, I hear you. Wherever you're at, hopefully I don't step on you. So the shop come together pretty good. Oh yes, there's gonna be a spot where people can sit and look at what they got, or just have some conversations if we ever get to that point that we open after this whole pandemic. What are you doing? Listen, hobo, you're gonna be going back outside if you tear that chair apart. That is not a tree. Cute little kitty though. Anyhow, I just wanted to give you guys a quick update. It was kind of not a quick update, but that's an update. That's how I do my updates. I'm hoping to get to doing some, when I get stuff in, I'll show what I got in and we'll talk about them. This album here you don't see too often. I love this album. Love that album. So that's it, folks. Thank you for sticking around. I know that I was going to do videos, the whole process of opening the shop, but man, when you get busy, it doesn't really happen that way. But you guys got a glimpse at a couple videos ago what I started out with and where we're sitting at right now. And now I need to get some courses to figure out how to run a store. Not a record store, but just a store in general, so I do everything properly. So I'm going to look at community college, and while the pandemic's gone, maybe there's some things that I can do online and learn the biz and make sure that the government is happy with me, because I really don't know what I'm going to do from here. I built it. Now it's to learn how to run it. So thank you for watching Golden Funnel Spin, everyone. Remember, hit that subscribe button down below, and I will see you in the next video. Remember, keep spinning.